Well, I had to check to see if my camera was on. Good morning, everybody. This is Pam. I'm getting ready to start my first tutorial, and I'm scared. Okay. I'm working on another little mini room for a friend of mine, Jay and Sia Beatty, on YouTube for Sibyl. And she wants a little powder room, Victorian bathroom. And I don't have a right way or a wrong way to do this. I just do it. So, first thing I usually do, I've got to try to figure out my little bathtub shape. I hope you all can see this, and I just kind of, I can't really draw. I just kind of sketch me out. I'm nervous. I'm always nervous when I make these videos, but I'm even more nervous trying to do a tutorial. But anyway, I just try to get a shape. And this isn't going to be very good. I usually end up shaping it more with my scissors. I'm so nervous. But anyway, and I just use scrap pieces of cardboard and stuff. So anyway, this is not, let's see if I can get it to come out. Okay, I make them work with that. So then, I just cut it out. And I hope I'm staying in the camera here. Like I said, there's no right or wrong way to do this, and if there was, I don't know. I've only been making these little miniatures whenever I entered Fiona's competition. And let's see. Well, that may look okay, maybe. Who knows? We just try it. If it don't work, we do it again. So what I have to do, and I don't want to get it too big, I'm checking to see. That'd probably be okay. Anyway, if it's not, we'll go from there. Let me just see if I can just wondering if I like that shape. But we're going to try it. If it don't come out, we'll do it again. So once I make one side, I've got to tell you, we're going to make the bathtub. Then I just trace around what I just did onto another piece of chipboard. Cut this side out. I'm going kind of hurriedly because I'm afraid I won't have enough time. My computer and camera is not set up in my craft room. And so I'm using my little digital camera on a little bitty tripod. Okay. Now we've got us two shapes for there. Now we've got to join these together. And what I do when I have to do this is curvy. See the difference in this chipboard? It's not as, it's more flexible than that. So, I forgot to turn my gun on to the glue gun to be getting it heated up. So, let me stop this for a minute. Okay, I'm back. Got my glue gun ready. I was looking at this and I'm thinking it's just a little bit too long. So, I'm going to just take my scissors and kind of square it up just a little bit on the ends and shorten it just a little bit. Like I said, if it don't come out right, I can always do it over and do it again. Cut that one. Now, I went back to my first piece of chipboard that I cut these out of, and what I need to do is get a bottom in the tub first. So, to do that, and I hope I'm still recording, I'm trying, and I forgot to tell you all, this is a tutorial for freestyle crafts or crafting. Fiona asked me to be on her design team. So, this is my first tutorial for it. And right now I'm just putting some glue on the bottom of this bathtub. And then I'm just going to plop it down right there because I just need the bottom to cover. I've got glue on me, always. And then I'm going to cover this bottom piece with glue. And like I said, I don't really know how to do it. This is just how I do it. I didn't even know I could do it. I ain't sure I can yet. But then I gotta put this about here. Gotta give a little width to the bathtub. And this way we'll have our bottom. And then this is dry. It's real simple. Once you get that on there, just take and cut around it. And also, if you've got any globs of glue, which I always do, you just cut those right off. And just kind of cut this even down here because you're going to be gluing another part to form the other part of the tub. Uh-oh, that one's tried to come loose on me. Go back and fix it. It has nothing much to support it. Well, I think it will be okay once I'm okay. Now to get this side piece to come up, I'm going to have to put some more glue on that one. Just run it down here. I'm just really nervous trying to do this and talk and show you all. I'm afraid it won't come out right because I haven't really ever tried to show anybody. Get that a little bit more. Okay. And I'm also afraid I'll run out of time. Okay. Now this, I'm just going to cut a narrow piece. I'm afraid my tub may not be quite wide enough, but maybe it will be. I'm just going to cut a thin piece of this cardboard here, and hopefully this will work the way I want it to. Okay. I'm just going to stick some glue on both sides. Try not to be messy with it, but my hand shakes and I can't help it. I'm covering all the surface on the side and the bottom with glue. Then I'm just going to set this right here and hold it up here and see where it curves. That takes care of the circular part. That tub isn't too narrow. Okay, then you just cut off the excess again. And up here, just kind of round it around at the tub. Okay, now I'll move that little piece. Okay, now we'll be putting something on top of this later to even out right there, so it will look more fluid. even. Now I'm going to leave that like that for now. I'm going to go ahead and take some of that roundness out because it looks more like a sled or a sleigh. That's all I did. Okay, now I'm going to do the same thing. We just need a little piece down here. So, are y'all as messy with glue as I am? I get it everywhere. Okay, we're going to run some along the bottom and the sides here of the tube. And again, we're just going to plop it down here and hold it up. And then trim off the excess. I'm sure after I do this a million more times, I hope that I'll get better at it and not have such a mess with my glue. Okay. Doesn't look like much right now, but next thing I'm going to do is paint it. So I'm going to cut this off and I'll come back in a minute.